I'm Shelby Cullinan, and this is a health feature. A new, smaller version of an already approved artificial heart recently made a big impact on one patient's life. A patient at the Ronald Reagan UCLA Medical Center became the first in the world to receive a successful heart transplant after receiving a smaller version of the experimental total artificial heart. The 50cc SynCardia temporary total artificial heart is a temporary heart designed for use by smaller patients. According to a University of California, Los Angeles press release, it's a smaller investigational version of the larger 70cc SynCardia heart, which was approved for use in people awaiting a transplant by the Federal Food and Drug Administration in 2004 and has been used by more than 1,440 patients worldwide. These artificial hearts are designed to help patients who are awaiting a heart transplant due to heart failure. The artificial hearts are temporary. They are removed when a patient received a real heart via a transplant. Dr. Mario Dang, professor of medicine and medical director of the Advanced Heart Failure Mechanical Support and Heart Transplant Program at UCLA, has more on the 44-year-old patient and the remarkable surgery that helped her.
If I talk about this 44-year-old woman's clinical course, it is remarkable as she was an emergently transferred patient from our colleagues and partners at Kaiser Permanente Southern California. She had a very advanced heart failure syndrome. She required a short-term VA ECMO, which is a short-term percutaneous assist heart pump for 12 hours. Next step after our team identified her as a heart transplantation candidate, she required immediately a so-called total artificial heart. The total artificial heart replaces both the left and the right side of the heart and can be used for a period up to months to years. The remarkable aspect in her situation was that she was too small for the currently FDA-approved total artificial heart. Fortunately, the FDA has a pending regulatory approval for a smaller total artificial heart, the so-called 50cc total artificial heart. The UCLA team asked for a one-time humanitarian device exemption. It was granted, so we could, within 12 hours of the patient's arrival at UCLA, proceed with a smaller total artificial heart. This therefore became the first total artificial heart, 50cc, in the Western United States, and then ultimately 3 weeks later, the first total artificial heart of this small size that led to a successful heart transplantation.
Dr. Dang adds it was important to make sure the patient herself fully and completely understood this option. He also explains the patient needed to reach a decision whether or not an artificial heart was something she was okay with within a 24-hour period.
She needed to understand this option within 24 hours, and then she needed to make a decision about this. At UCLA, we have a culture that tries to frame all the modern achievement in medicine in a humanism framework, where we not only want to heal humankind by prolonging life, improving life, and alleviating suffering, but to deliver acts of kindness, meaning. In this moment, it was most important for us that we, as a team of white coats, outlined this option, but then made sure that she, as the boss over her destiny, understood what it meant to live with this total artificial heart, followed by a second surgery, the heart transplantation, and was okay with that.
Thankfully, the patient was on board.
The patient was okay with that. She embraced the concept. It was very important that we had our team, our multidisciplinary team, between the physicians, meaning the cardiologists, the surgeons, the psychiatrists, the immunologists, the infectious disease doctors, but our transplant coordinators, our mechanical circular support coordinators, our social workers, our psychologists present to help her make that decision. This is basically our conviction. Only if we take her basic human right of understanding this process seriously, then can she make the decision, and only then can she benefit from this with regard to longevity and good quality of life.
Dr. Dang is happy to add the patient is doing very well. And what does this mean for the future? A new life-saving option for many different kinds of patients.
The smaller size of the total artificial heart has large implications. It will allow to expand the population of advanced heart failure patients who have a so-called biventricular failure, who are small. For example, younger recipients, typically in the age range between 10 and 18 years, but also smaller adults, often females, to benefit from this invasive but potentially life-saving therapy.
The 50cc total artificial heart is currently in an FDA-approved study. UCLA officials said they plan to begin enrolling study patients in the near future. Make sure to speak with your doctor about advances in the medical field that may affect you and your condition.